Hi everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a brand new 2024 Bavaria Yachts Vida 33. So let me show you some of the particulars about this brand new vessel that we have in stock here in Marina Del Rey, California.
All right, so here we are, starting out the bows. You can see we have a nice single bow roller with a Lumar Delta anchor. Gets tucked up there really nicely. We have the open bow concept here, and so this is a really nice feature. It also has a table that I'm going to show you here in a little bit that'll drop down with a filler cushion, turning that into a lounge. This is the dark smoke gray hardtop edition. And as we walk back, you're gonna see again, just these cool lines that this vessel has to offer. You have a hard windshield closing up, a forward windshield up on the port side. This side is open, but you can easily enclose this with a hard macro long glass, and then off to the back if so desired as well. Now, this is the very first Vida 33 we brought in here with the fully submergible swim platform. So you're gonna see this on a lot of larger yachts, but what I've done here is I've dropped this all the way into the down position. And then obviously when underway, it goes flush with these aft decks. And then when the motors are up, which I'll show you, this lifts all the way up so the motors can tilt fully out of the water. But is it a neat feature here on a vessel of this size? Allows you to kind of get in and out of the water, have some fun, play around, let the kids, you know, go through and utilize, you know, everything it possesses. One thing I really like about it is when you do walk down, you have steps. And then again, it allows you to have probably about 4 inches into the water itself right here. And then again, these collapsing steps as you raise it will collapse right up. So it's nice, but it's a nice easy mechanical system here. Again, since we're back here, this is powered by Mercury 250 horsepower V8 engines. One thing that I just found out about these is they have a sport exhaust mode. And so you see the decibels moving, and it's totally changed the sound of the outboard. So you have a really throaty, you know, sport mode on the Mercury engines. But then again, if you just want to go ahead and have more of a quiet sound, there it goes. It shuts it down. I'm taking you back, but we're really quiet back here now. So a really neat feature found on the Mercury Verado 250 horsepower engines. You know, a little area here that'll close off, a little gate just underneath that is our shore power inlet, our flag holder here, and these are all flexi teak cockpit floor, so zero maintenance. A very large storage area underneath this, and then this large bench seat. So when the engines are up, this bench seat slides forward about to here, and then that allows the engines to tilt up. There's storage underneath the bench seats as well. This could be a dedicated life raft storage here, or additional cooler storage. And then again, you have storage underneath all of this. The table's pretty unique because this also drops down. The table leaves fold out, and then there's a filler cushion that makes this into a large lounging berth as well too. Down below this, we have additional little bit of storage, but fuel tank access, trash can, refrigerator, storage, a little sink here. This top opens up, and we have a little single electric burner, a stovetop, and then additional countertop space. It's a teak top here on the cabinet. And then there's also this little extension table here that opens that up. So very, very unique, very open, very modern. Overhead, we have the hard roof, and then we have the soft top sunshade. Now this pulls out, collapses back in, and then same with this. This all collapses back and locks into position so you can get as much sun as you want. And then if not, obviously closes off and gives you the shade that you're looking for, like what we're seeing now. We do have an additional Dometic fridge located right underneath this bench seat. Fusion speakers, a Fusion stereo. That's obviously tied in with all the Bluetooth equipment. We're gonna go to the helm. Here at the helm, we have 3 forward facing seats, which are nice. We have really cool LED lighting that changes multiple colors. This is a phone charger, so you can clip this in here and control the music, VHF, and then we have our Simrad display. So this is GPS and everything integrated into that as well too. This is the aft platform positioning sensor. So right now it's telling us no lifting up of the engines because it's in the down position. And then we have all of our windlass controls and then all of our main breakers as well too. Off to the starboard of the steering wheel, we have our bow thruster control and then the new Mercury throttle control too. So this is a really neat system. This will allow us, you know, to have a lot of control over the engine. And then we have the full joystick right here. So this is a very fun, easy boat to handle. If you're looking for something that is just great for entertaining with massive amounts of people that could be accommodated here, zip out to the islands. She's fast, it's comfortable, and yeah, definitely a really great entertaining boat. As we come down below, we have two steps here. We have the controls for the lights. So the lights here, as I mentioned, we can actually change the colors. So down below, yeah, we can go from red to pink to blue to purple, and it really just changes us out. We can also dim them. So it's a really neat feature, and you have three controls for that. So up, forward, in here, in the main down below section, salon of the vessel, let's call it, and then in the cockpit as well too. So it's a cool feature that allows you to turn them on, off, and adjust with the colors. As I mentioned, Simrad VHF with the remote up right at the helm. And then this is our main control panel. So this is navigation systems, interior, battery monitoring, and so forth from here. But this we brought in with the ultra leather interior. So it's kind of, you know, a nice bright, clean look to it. This table does drop down and turn into a bed. There is a filler cushion for this as well too, that I have stowed aft, and then little mini binds with a little hatch there so you can kind of see out. Storage underneath all of the seating up forward as well too. We have outlets so you can put a TV here if so desired, and then walking into our head shower compartment. So shower compartment, the shower wand is right here, and then obviously our mixing controller, and then we have the sink itself, and then the electric quiet flush toilet. So very simple, very nice, very modern, and a little storage cabinet below here, little mirror, and then a plexiglass door that will close off into position. And yeah, it's just everything you really need in you know, a nice day boat, or for extended use, you know, out on the islands and just playing around with your family. So we're gonna come back through here. I'm gonna walk you up to the forward section. And as I mentioned earlier, we have a window that comes across here and a little door that closes off. So when you are running underway, you're able to close this off. But again, be able to have access up here for this really amazing seating area. This table does drop down, turn into a bed, so you can turn it into this full lounge. And then we also have our Fusion stereo controls and then a USB charging outlet here. So we can, you know, adjust the stereo, we can charge your phone, you have great grab handles, cup holders, and you're utilizing this forward section of the boat, which is really impressive. All right, coming back aft, so I'll show you a nice aft perspective of the vessel. And then I can show you this cool little feature with these both turn on. And then now there goes our swim platform raising up. So as I mentioned, when you're running, you're keeping it right here in level position, and it kind of stops. So now we're in level position. Again, this is where you're gonna be utilizing the boat, where you're gonna be running it. And then when you are wanting to tilt up the engine, you're gonna have another section where it is gonna come all the way up. Just as so, if I push the buttons correctly. And there it is. And of course, obviously this will support, you know, you in the up position so you can have the kids or whatever jump off of this if they so desire. But yeah, just a nice little function here. And then as I mentioned before we tilt up the engines, this seat will slide up forward. Then it'll allow us the angle that we need to tilt up the engines. Found this video to be helpful and informative. Obviously the Vida 33 is a great boat with a lot of features, amazing amount of seating capacity, lounging capacity, just a fun, easy boat to single hand for you, your family. Obviously with the twin outboards, she is very efficient. And then with the joystick and the bow thruster, just effortless control at the helm. So if you have any questions whatsoever, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and then hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.